Data integration offers a simplified interface to load balances for reconciliations. You can load balances from flat files or external source systems. You can format data before loading and use different modes to handle different data load scenarios. Let's look at the differences between the three load modes. Full refresh mode removes all balances across all locations for the period and reloads the balances for the specified locations. Snapshot mode removes all balances for the specified locations for the period and reloads the balances for the same specified locations. When you import balances using merge mode, the data load updates only balances whose values have changed. This is useful when you load large data files on an ongoing basis and only need to reload some of the balances at the same location. You access the data integration interface under Application from the Data Exchange card. I'll create a data integration that loads balances from a file. Data integration guides you through a workflow to complete the setup tasks. On the General tab, enter a name and optional description. For location, you can select an existing location or create a new one. I'll create a new location called GL Balances. Next, select a data source. I'll select File and upload the data file with changed balances. For the target, select Reconciliation Compliance Balances, then select a category. The entered category selected here maps to the entered currency bucket. Let's take a look at file options for the source data file. You can select a different file by opening the file browser. You can make changes to the type, delimiter, encoding, and drill URL fields. Here's a preview of the file contents. You can assign a header row for column names. Oracle recommends that you include a header row in your data file. The header row is used to populate dimension mappings during integration setup. If you need to define or rename columns to map to the target application, specify them here. You can add or edit attributes assigned to a location. Save your integration before proceeding to the next task in the workflow. You can also continue working on your integration later. Next, you map dimensions to specify how source columns map to the dimensions in the target application. The first column of the mapping grid specifies the field number from the source file. The second column specifies the column name from the source file. The third column specifies the target dimension. Because the profile format in my target application includes both company and account segments separated by a hyphen, I'll add dimension rows for profile and map the source columns to match the format. If you're using group reconciliations, include individual mappings for the subsegments you want to group across. In this example, I want to group reconciliations by company or account or both, so I included individual mappings for these segments. I'll also add a currency target dimension and map it to the currency code column in my file. To import only changed balances and retain existing data for the same location, you set up a special merge ID dimension for each balance you want to load into the target application. To set up the merge ID dimension, you must map all source dimensions in the file along with currency to the merge ID dimension. The merge ID will be used to uniquely identify each row in the file. I'll save my entries and continue to the next task. Map members is where you define data load mappings for each target dimension. You map members to define how dimension values are translated from source to target during the data load. In this example, for the account target dimension, formatting skips the leading character from the source member. For the company target dimension, formatting skips two leading characters from the source member. For the profile target dimension, formatting constructs the target member from multiple source members. I'll add mappings to the target dimensions. For the source type dimension, the target mapping must be set to either source system or subsystem using lowercase letters. Save the integration. You can now manage the integration from the data exchange card. For example, you can change the source file, remap dimensions or members, and so on. Let's test the integration. The source data file contains updated balances for only 3 accounts. These are the reconciliations where data will be updated. I'll load these balances from the periods card. First, I'll create a data load execution for the period. I'll provide a name and select merge for mode. For location, I'll select GL balances, then click OK to execute the data load. The data load execution completed without errors. Let's check reconciliation balances again. Balances for accounts listed in the source data file have been updated successfully. Balances for other accounts have been retained for the same location. To learn more, visit docs.oracle.com.